the Yankee situation as far as like Luke Voit, Anthony Rizzo,
yeah,
and what that's going to look like.
Yeah, I mean, there's kind of been some comments that people have maybe taken the wrong way. I haven't personally. I understand it, and I'm glad that it was the way it was. But for anyone who's unfamiliar with the situation, obviously, Voit and Rizzo play the same primary position at first base. And Voit's been producing pretty well since COVID, since Rizzo was on the COVID IL. Rizzo did just come back. So I think I talked about this on a previous episode whenever we did acquire Rizzo. It's like, when everybody's healthy, what do we do to make sure everyone's in the lineup that's the best possible hitters?
Right.
And, you know, I think being Anthony Rizzo has won a platinum glove, he would get the majority of the starts at first base, and then you have Voit plug in at DH, which means you have to have Giancarlo Stanton playing the outfield. But now he's been doing it for about 3 weeks, and he's been fine. He hasn't done it every day, but he's been playing outfield pretty regularly. So I think you gotta maybe, like, you rotate guys with days off too. Like, give Voit or Rizzo a day off every once in a while so you can plug Stanton in at DH or something. Because not that we can afford to really have them have an off day, but everybody needs off days nowadays.
Yeah.
So, I mean, I think the ideal lineup for me, if we made the playoffs today and everybody happened to be healthy, I think you got to go DJ leading off at second base, Rizzo first base hitting second, Judge in right, Gallo in center, Stanton in left. Then you got Voit DHing, Gary at catcher, Gio at third, and Gleyber at short. I think that you can't play the what-if game. Like, what if Stanton gets hurt, or what if Judge gets hurt? Or,
yeah.
That's, like, irrelevant, because now you have the logjam, and if you sit Voit, that just doesn't make any sense, because he was a homer leader right last year in the league, and I think he's hitting above, like, 450 in his past 10 games or something crazy. So you're not going to bench him, and you just traded for Rizzo, so you're not going to bench Rizzo.
No.
And you're not going to bench Stanton because you're paying him all this money. So I don't know. I mean, I'm curious, like, do you agree with that? And do you think that once everyone's healthy, this is something that Aaron Boone would actually do every day?
I think so. I mean, assuming Stanton stays on the field, if he's right. If he's going to stay in left, I mean, it's a big if. But yeah, no, yeah. I mean, I don't know. Yeah, you just have this logjam of, like, big sluggers who just all play like the same position. So, I mean, yeah, maybe this looks different next season, depending on contracts and such, but I think now that's the way to go.
I just feel like you have to, like, there's no way. And, like, Voit had said some things like, I deserve to play just as much as Rizzo deserves to play. And
yeah,
some people were almost taking it as like a dig at Rizzo from Voit, and it's like,
no.
If you see them around each other, they're getting along fantastically.
That's
so
a soft
that's
take.
Not it.
No.
And, like, he was just saying some other things. Like, he's like, the reason they got Rizzo is obviously because of injuries, and that's on me because I haven't been on the field. And he's, like, taking responsibility for it. Like,
right.
I think he's entitled to be, like, I think a lot of people were viewing it as he was mad. And I don't think that that's not what he was pushing. I think he was pushing that, like, it's frustrating if he doesn't get playing time, but he thinks he should just as much as Rizzo. I think it's more so a team perspective, because Voit wants them both to be in the lineup at the same time, no matter what it is or how it happens.
Mm-hmm.
Because that gives us the best chance to win. If anybody has seen Luke Voit interviews, he's very, like, team-oriented. He wants to win. Like, he's not talking about his personal stats very much.
Yeah.
I feel like if people are viewing what he said the wrong way, don't. Because they both deserve to play. This is the lineup that has to be there. And not everybody's healthy at the moment anyway, so it doesn't necessarily matter. But that's got to be the lineup. And, dude, you got, like, Gleyber Torres hitting ninth. I know he's not having his best season, but, like,
no, that's still absurd.
2 years ago, he was, like, our three hitter a lot. So, I mean, it's just crazy. I mean, I think this has got to be what we do, though. There's other way around it.
Voit led the league in home runs last year. So, sure, he got banged up, but, like,
yeah.
absolutely deserve a spot. And then, I don't see what he said as anything.
No.
Out of the box, so.
And I don't know if you've seen Stanton at all, but he hasn't looked bad in the outfield. I don't know if you've seen any games. He's played some games in left and some games in right.
Okay.
You know, I think you can kind of flip-flop Gallo or Judge in center field.
Right.
To, like, put either one of them. Like, Stanton's got to play a corner. Obviously, you're not going to put Stanton in center field. No. But I think either one of them, you could flop whichever way you want it. But, yeah, man, I mean, Yanks are hot right now, too. 8 in a row, I think, maybe 9 in a row that we've won now. So,
and taken over from Boston, the wild card.
Yeah, so it'll be interesting.